We're looking at multiples of 8 in this video, and all we really need to do is multiply 8 by any whole number and we get a multiple of 8. So we could start by multiplying 1 by 8, 2, and so on. So 3 eighths are 24, 4 eighths 32, 5 eighths 40, and so on. We could just go on. But we can choose any number to multiply by. So we've multiplied 1 to 12 by 8, but I could just do, I don't know, 100 times 8. So that'll give us 800, or another multiple of 8 would be 840. Another one would be 1,192. So all these numbers are multiples of 8. There are an infinite number of them. So it's not like when you find the factors of a number where there are a certain number of factors to be found. Once you found them, you're done. With this, if you were asked to write down the multiples of 8, you'd be going on forever, wouldn't you? So sometimes you would be asked to write down the multiples of 8 between two numbers or less than a certain number. Or you might be asked whether or not a number is a multiple of 8. So for example, if you were asked, is 24 a multiple of 8? What you would do is divide 24 by 8. And in this case, you get a whole number, 3. So yes, 24 is a multiple of 8 because 24 is 3 times 8. But you could have, another number. Let's choose 102. So if we want to know if 102 is a multiple of 8, well, when we divide 8 into that, we're going to get not an exact number, are we? We're going to get 12, and then we get a remainder of 6. So it's 12 and 6 eighths, or 12.75. But as soon as you don't get a whole number for an answer, then you know that the number is not a multiple of 8. So 102 is not a multiple of 8. So 8 is not a factor of 102. Another important thing to look at with multiples is the lowest common multiple when you've got two or more numbers. So we'll look at that in the next video.